Education does not dictate knowledge. If I am highly educated, does it mean that I am highly knowledgeable? And if someone is not highly educated, does it mean that the person is not highly knowledgeable or is he not having a degree of knowledge? Let me give an example. When a mobile phone company came with an inbuilt SIM card, what was the catch in that? You cannot change the handset, because if you change the handset, the number will also go. So I am telling you, we decided that we should have that mobile service or we should not have that mobile service. But some of us are born engineers. With all due regard and respect to engineering, some of us who are not actually engineers, they actually decoded that mobile phone. And when that company which brought that SIM card along with that mobile phone came to know that there are great people outside us, they found out, why cannot they be inside us? 9 years back, 10 years back, a company came up with a mobile phone with an inbuilt SIM card. The reason for that, people cannot always change the SIM card and put another SIM card into that. But someone from the audiences decoded that SIM card, made that mobile handset free of a SIM card, and completely challenged the technology of the company. And that person was not an expert in technology. Why I give this example? Anyone can be free to do an experiment, and from that experiment, if a company learns, it can change the way in which a brand is built. So consumer knowledge has to be respected. The way in which it has to be respected, we have to take care of that without affecting the privacy and the delicacy of the consumer relationship that is involved. Who creates the vision? No. There is something called as a vision for the brand. Basically, what is vision? Who creates the vision? Is the promoter of the company creating the vision? Are the employees of the company creating the vision? Or are the consultants of the company creating a vision? Or can a vision be created only in the beginning and can it not be modified? That is another aspect. And can at any point of time vision get diluted? In 1994, or for example in 1983, for the first time when Maruti Udyog came up with the first car in India on a large scale with Suzuki, what could have been the vision of that company in those days? And what must have been the vision of that company in 1997? What happened in 1997 which was a big game changer for automobile industry, four-wheeler? Can you tell me what happened in 1997? What happened in 1983 was clear. Maruti Udyog Limited started making cars. Something happened in 1997. Yes, anyone? I want this to be interactive. For the first time, Maruti Suzuki Limited started facing genuine competition in passenger cars. Tata Indica, Hyundai Santro, Daewoo Cielo, and various other brands. Between 1983 and 1997, for 14 years, literally there was no competition for Maruti Udyog Limited. Am I right? I am not talking on the basis of statistical data and applying some mathematical techniques. It's just simple, which all of us know. See, providing economy car to the masses of the people was the vision of Maruti Udyog Limited when Mrs. Gandhi inaugurated the first car in 1983. 97, the competition started. First 14 years there was no competition, literally no competition. Last 14 years, from 97 to 2011, another 14 years. Just see those 14 years and this 14 years, the difference. Between 1983 and 1997, how many models came out? And between 97 and 2011, how many models came out? You can count the number of models. 1983 to 1997, people, there was a Maruti 800 basic model. There was Maruti 1000, which came on to be known as Esteem. There was Maruti Gypsy. And Wagon-R just started coming out. And there was one or two other models. But after 1997, you can't even count how many models have come. And the vision of the company completely changed. From a passenger economy car making company for audiences to a car making company for all segments. There is a 2.5 lakh car, there is a 6 lakh car, there is a 7 lakh car, and a company is planning to come up with a car which can be projected at an MRP of 15 lakhs, which is slowly and gradually moving. Vision of a brand should change with time. I am not saying everything is right with the vision, but vision cannot be our prison. Identity is required, but we cannot make our vision a so-called prison in which we cannot go out. There is something which you call in management out of the box. And Maruti Suzuki Limited is supposedly a government organization, if I am not wrong. And normally what is perceived of a government organization, we all know. And sometimes when someone talks about a government organization having a vision, so people laugh. They have a vision. Sochna padega. No. They have a vision. Why? Because they don't have any option. They don't have any option.